let me tell you this. Have you ever found yourself in the lion's den? No, I'm not talking about going to a zoo or traveling to Africa and to experience a lion there. But have you ever found yourself in a moment where you feel like you're facing so much trouble, so many challenges, they're so overwhelming, they're so great, you feel like you are facing the lions? You're having a Daniel experience, taken from the story in the Old Testament. When Daniel, who was one who had prayed three times a day and had a spiritual practice, a strong discipline in his faith in God, was being challenged by those who were jealous of him and wanted to have him thrown into the lion's den. The king made a special decree saying no one could pray, no one could worship, no one could do anything other than worship the king or pray to the king or acknowledge the king. And Daniel continued his spiritual practice. Lo and behold, the king said, because you've disobeyed the decree, those who gathered together in great sadness began to gather up Daniel and throw him into the lion's den, and he experienced a great challenge. You can imagine. Can you imagine? Yes, I think you can, because many of us have felt like we have been thrown to the lions, that we have been facing the issues of troubles and challenges within our life that seem so overwhelming. And the big question then is, when you are facing the lion's den, where do you go? What do you do? Where do you go? What do you do? What have you been doing? And where have you been going? Because the scripture invites us to find the secret to overcoming the lions, to overcoming the challenges, to overcoming the roar of that which may seem to be the great challenge in our life, or the trouble, or that may be that which we are fearing or afraid of, or that which we are in the midst of stress and trial with. Where do we go? Where the only place you can go is to go within. That's right. We're called to go within. Where it's the only place that you need to go. Oh, many of us may run to someone else. Can you help me? Would you help me? Help me calm down. Help me. I'm stressed. I'm worried. Help me this way. Help me that way. Would you do this for this or me? Maybe I need to sit and just go away into nature. Maybe I need to take a walk in the woods. Maybe all those things can be helpful. But the greatest thing that you can do, the most important thing you can do, is to go within. For it is there we find the overcoming power. It's the only place where you're going to find that power that will enable you to be the overcomer, that speaks to the lion, that speaks directly to the challenge, that speaks directly to the trouble, and says, peace be still, because you've gone within to discover that perfect peace, and you found it there. You know that in medieval times, the king would build a castle. The castle wasn't just for him. The castle quite often was built by the villagers as a place of sanctuary, a place of safety. When the enemy came in, or people who came to rob and steal, people would run to the castle walls and come across the drawbridge and find safety and sanctuary within the castle walls, within this fortress, and pull up the drawbridge and find that this was a place where they were free from those terrors and challenges of the world around them. They went within the castle walls. They went within the kingdom. They went within this place of the king. You know that there's an invitation for you in the midst of your trial and your challenge to come into the place of the king, to come into the dwelling place, that centered space within your very being where you're going to find the sanctuary, the safety, the peace, the joy, the strength you need to be the overcomer that you are. Do you know that you have been invited to the kingdom? That's right. Come on in. In ancient times, there would be great celebrations, and people would say, run through the village and say, the king is welcoming everyone to the castle. Everyone is welcome to come on in. Come on in, and we're going to celebrate together. We're going to have a great feast. There's going to be a great time of celebration. There's going to be something wonderful happening. Come on in. The Spirit of God has been constantly offering you an invitation. Come on in to the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God, the realm of God. It's found deep within. It's within each and every one of us. Jesus said the kingdom of heaven is within, and yet so many of us have heard sermon after sermon after sermon. The kingdom of heaven will be someday when I die. I will go to that place called heaven. But right now, I guess I have to face the lions on my own. Oh, that's not true. For as we have received this invitation and we walk into this divine presence, we come into the kingdom that was deep within our whole being. We come into that centered space. We come into that place of knowing the divine. We come into that wonderful place. Oh, we're in heaven. Heaven being the realm of God. Heaven being the consciousness and awareness of the divine. You know, we read in the Bible that many people talk, oh, when we get to heaven, there's going to be all these streets of gold and wonderful golden mansions and all these kind of things, thinking that that's someday when we die. But it's describing right here and now. That you're invited to come into the kingdom, the realm of God, and not to experience literal golden streets. But it's a metaphor us of saying that you are called to walk every day on golden streets of prosperity and abundance and blessing. That you're called to walk on those streets and to live each and every day when you are in the kingdom, when you're dwelling in the presence, when you're in that place. You're going to find all that is of heaven. Oh, heaven is this place of eternal joy. Eternal peace, no tears and no sorrow. We think about heaven as this wonderful place of being there in community with all the kind of love of God surrounding us. That's right. You're invited to experience that today, right now. The invitation is resounding out as the trumpets are sounding. Come into the kingdom for the celebration. You're afraid, you're troubled, you're worried, you're stressed, you're challenged. Come on into the sanctuary. Come on into the kingdom of God. Go within. Discover this divine presence that is this eternal peace. Okay, you may say, wait a minute, but how do I go within? You talk about going within all the time. How do I go within? To go within is this beginning of an acknowledgement, an awareness of this presence. It starts there. Jesus said, to inherit the kingdom of heaven, you must be born again. Now, we have trouble sometimes understanding what this word is when you say born again. Born anew, to start anew, to begin a new beginning, to actually change and to move in the spirit of repentance from thinking this way to making a new turn 180 degrees to thinking that way. We like to call it a new thought. That describes this whole movement of what we're part of. Beginning with a new thought, changing our thinking, changing our outlook, because so many of us have lived in the bondage of error thinking. It's held us back. It's confined us. It's restricted us, that we think we are all alone. We're separate from God. We're removed from this divine presence in some way. Or somehow we've got to plead and beg to try to get God to pay attention to us. Maybe we got to do more. We've got to try to live better. We got to do all these kind of things. And then maybe God will pay attention to us. Maybe then God will hear us. Maybe then our prayer will be understood. No, it's simply this wonderful work that we need to do of unlearning. That's right. Unlearning all the things that our world has taught us in ignorance and in error thinking that hold us back. From the ability to go within when you're facing challenges, to go within and to know that there is peace, there is serenity, there is joy, there is comfort, there is prosperity, there is blessing, there's all these things in the kingdom, and the kingdom is within. The kingdom just describes for us this divine presence. It's simply a metaphor for understanding that when you're in the presence of God, when you begin to acknowledge the presence of God is here right now, and I love John's meditation this morning, it says, I am here. I am here. And where is here? The presence of God. Because God is good all the time, all the time. God is good, and right here, right now, God is good. Right now, this very moment, the goodness of God is here. It's meant to be experienced, meant to be felt. As we go within, we become aware of this divine presence. We become aware of this kingdom within us. 1 John chapter 5, verse 4 says, because everyone born of God overcomes the world. Wow, We're asking, where do we go when we're facing challenges, when we're in the midst of the lion's den, when we're facing trouble? Where do we go? Well, we just pause and we become an overcomer right here, right now, right where we are, born of God, born anew. To be born again is to begin anew right here and now, to change our thinking. And in this moment, just like that, we make a change. We make a change. We begin to think, you know what? I was afraid, but the presence of God is here and I have nothing to be afraid of. Change that thought just like that. I was feeling I was all alone, but there's not a spot where God is not, and God is here right now. Change that thought just like that. And a new thought begins to change, and we have this born anew experience. It's a different experience that happens within our life. There's a transformation that happens. For so many, it has been a journey where they're saying, well, if I just could get Jesus into my heart, if I could get him into my life, if I could just pull some Jesus into me. Oh, let me tell you, you just need to let some Jesus out, because there's so much within you already. Just begin to let it out. You don't need to beg it in. You don't need to plead it in. You need to buy it in. You need to barter for it to come in. You just need to experience this born again experience of saying, I know I am born of God, of God. To be born of God is that we are not separate. We're not sinners, but we're not born in a sinful nature. That's not who we are. We're born in this divine blessing. How? You're born in the goodness of God. For God is good all the time. All the time is God is good. And the day you were born, when your soul entered this earthly journey, God's goodness was there. You were born in the goodness, in the blessing, in the divine experience of God in you, through you at all times. And in this God, you live and breathe and have your being. This is the wonderful understanding that ignites the power of our faith. I'm born of God. That's right. I am now embraced this new thinking and this new thought that I am of God. That is this right now, this experience. I am of God. That's what you're experiencing. You're experiencing the voice of God, the presence of God, the love of God, the hands of God, the feet of God, the very body of God. That's right. That's who you are. You are of God. You are here of God. When you realize that the divine presence is in you, what a transformation it makes in our life. And suddenly, because of that understanding, our faith can go to a new level. We can speak to that lion and say, be still. We can speak to that challenge and say, be gone. You have no power here. We can speak to that wonderful presence of God and invite it to ignite joy, peace, and all the essence of heaven right here, right now. The kingdom of heaven is meant to be experienced right here, right now, in this moment. I am here. I am here in the kingdom. I've gone within. And that's where my strength and my peace is. So what's the best defense for us when these lions come up against us? When we feel like life has thrown us into a lion's den? When we feel like we've been thrown down to be devoured by the challenges and the troubles of this world? What's the best defense for these challenges? What's the best preparation? Oh, I can't tell you enough. The best preparation is given just through this very example of the story of Daniel. Daniel's had a spiritual practice of prayer, three times a day, morning, noon, night. He opened up his windows towards heaven. He opened up the soul, you might say. It's a wonderful word picture, a metaphor of Daniel opening up his spiritual life, the very essence of himself, opening it up to allow this wonderful awareness to rise within him, of the kingdom of heaven in him, through him, and around him. We should not be waiting until there's an emergency to pray. Ooh, because so many of us live in what I want to call crisis Christianity. You know what? There's a crisis, and suddenly, ooh, we are super Christians. Yes, we are Christians then. We are spiritual people because there's a crisis going on right now. And when there's a problem, oh my Lord, get that Bible out, dust it off, find out it quickly. Someone call the preacher. What was his name? And what's the name of the church I go to? I can't even figure out what it is, but I'm in crisis. Trust me, I have experienced that in 43 years of pastoral ministry. Many people call and say, Reverend, I attend your church. Well, I did 10 years ago. And I'm a faithful member 10 years ago. I haven't been back to church since, but I'm in crisis now. Can you help me? And you want to say, well, wait. The crisis comes to you and your inability to overcome is part of the choice you've made in life where you haven't prepared yourself. There is a spiritual practice of preparation that we do every day as we are in prayer. As we're in meditation, you know what happens for us? We strengthen that union with the power and presence of God. It becomes sewn in stronger. The threads stronger. The weaving is stronger. It's suddenly you're being pulled more in. It's a tighter connection. It's not something that, oh, in crisis, what's the name of God? Oh, well, how do I pray? Someone find that prayer. Someone call someone. And because I need a prayer. Oh, no. You've been communing with God all along. And that union is there, that you just can whisper as you go within in the midst of that crisis. When that lion begins to roar at you, you face that lion and say, peace, be still. Because I've gone within and I know exactly what to do. There is that strong union. For what is within us is greater than what's in the world. That's right. Do you know that? What's within you already is greater than anything that's already in the world. Now, you may turn to the world for all kinds of solutions, for challenges and trials and tribulations and stress, and you may turn to all kinds of things to try to find out what can be the solution to help you overcome it. But what is within you is the of God, the born of God, the essence of God, the power, the strength, the peace, the calm, the assurance, everything that you need, it's within you. And it's greater than that which is in the world. So when we understand that we are not of the world, but we are for the world. You realize that? You're not of this world, but you are divine. And you are here to be the presence for this world. For this world. Jesus called you the light of the world. Jesus said, you're the light. You're the light. You're the light. You're the light of the world. That's what you're here for. You are here for the world, for others to wake. When you acknowledge this wonderful born of God experience within you, suddenly you realize I am the light for the world. I am the light that's supposed to shine in my neighborhood, in my community, in my home, at work, wherever I am. I am when I go to the store, when I'm driving down Interstate 85, whatever I am the light of the world, and I'm here for the world. I'm not of the world, but I'm here for the world because I realize that I am born of God, and I am this overcomer, and I'm called then to demonstrate, to show, to reveal how you overcome this stress and trials and tribulations in your life. Oh, my Lord, do we need some role models? We do. We need some role models of overcomers. We've seen far too many people acquiesce and give in. They resign to quit, to call it a day. They walk out on life because they said, you know, it's too hard, it's too difficult, the troubles are too great, the challenge is too overwhelming. I want to quit. I want to resign. I want to give up. And I want to tell you this, that is an error in our thinking because you are here meant to be a demonstration of the power and presence of God in a lion's den. You're called to be Daniel. That's who you are. I want to give you a new name today. It's Daniel. Whether it be that of your gender, you say, well, I'm a woman, you're going to call me Daniel. I'm calling you metaphorically. That you are called to be this overcoming witness for the world to see you demonstrating it. Your new name is Daniel. That's right. Move out in the world. I'm Daniel. I'm the one who's been in the lion's den. I faced those lions. I overcame those lions. I looked at that challenge. I said to that challenge, be gone. You have no power here because I've gone within. And within, I found the presence of God igniting and working within me to unfold all that I need within my life. I am not a quitter. I am not walking out. I'm not giving up. I'm not resigning. Why? Because I'm Daniel, and I'm the light of the world. That's right. When we begin to realize this, what happens is that we begin to be the kind of people, we're not praying to withstand the blows of the world around us, of life, but praying to release the very power of God. Because that's a big difference in how we pray. Oh, God, help me with this challenge. Oh, help me. It's going to topple me over. It's going to just knock me over. I don't know if I can make it. I don't know. Wait a minute. You're the power within you. You don't need to pray asking God to help you withstand the blows of life. Your prayer now is, I'm praying to release the power of God. I am releasing now that divinity in me. I am releasing that wonderful, infinite presence of God that already knows how to speak to the storm, speak to the lion, speak to the trial, speak to the challenge, and say, be gone. Jesus demonstrated it on the boat crossing the Sea of Galilee. The disciples were panicking and fearful, and they were facing a lion of their own in that storm that was tossing the boat to and fro, and Jesus was asleep. And they wake up Jesus, and he just says, peace be still. Jesus goes within to the divine power and presence, knowing that his prayer comes from an understanding. I release this power. I release this presence. I release this understanding. I'm not asking for, Jesus wasn't saying, oh, this storm is too great. I don't know if we can overcome it. Help us to sustain the boat in the midst of the storm because it may help us at least make it to the other side. No. Jesus said, peace be still. We're called to be the kind of light in this world, a role model example that can say to the challenges that we face, peace. Just be still. And in that stillness, know that divine presence, God, is at work and accomplishing all that needs to be worked on and accomplished within our life. We have to begin to realize that this God in us, that we are of God, is a new way of thinking. And we have to think then from this, I am born of God. And what I am is I am of God in this space right here and now. And when we say that, what we're saying is I'm truly aware that I am wholly equipped. We can say holy, H-O-L-Y, equipped, or W-H-O-L-Y, equipped. Holy means completely equipped, fully equipped. Wholly equipped. That means everything that you need. When you understand you're born of God, you are born of this holy essence, equipping you with the power and presence and authority to speak to storms, to speak to trials, to speak to the lions. Be quiet. Be still. Hush. You have no power here. Holy means that I am godly. And godly means I am fully, completely equipped with all that I need. And when this becomes your daily mantra, I'm wholly equipped. That's right. I'm wholly equipped. That's right. You know who I am? I'm Daniel. And I'm wholly equipped because I have this spiritual practice that I've been going through over and over again. I've been in prayer. I've been in meditation. I've been strengthening this union with God. I am realizing and fully walking in awareness of who I am. And who I am is fully, wholly equipped. Equipped to face everything. Because then what happens is you realize you are connected, never rejected. Mm-hmm. You are connected with the divine and never rejected. Oh, there's too many times we've heard sermons about how you've been rejected by God. God has turned you away. God doesn't want a fellowship with you. God is not in a relationship with you. Because this idea that the church is constantly preaching that several people, certain types of people, are rejected, alienated, removed, not to be part of. They're rejected, but no. The Spirit of God is telling us you're already connected. And our spiritual practice then is to, can I use this word, vibrate? To vibrate, that's right, give off this frequency, give us this intensity, to vibrate with our knowing. To vibrate in such a way that we said, I know I'm wholly equipped. I know I'm born of God. I know this. And what happens is when you know this and when you live this and you're in the midst of a challenge, you know what you're going to attract? You're going to attract the goodness. You're going to attract the strength. It will come to you. It's interesting. Have you ever studied alchemy? Alchemy meaning a transformation, change. A perfect example is metal. Turning metal into gold, there has to be some gold in the metal to turn it into gold, okay? So sometimes they're going to take lead that has a little bit of gold in it, and they're going to change the frequency, the vibration of that until the gold begins to rise out of the metal, and it begins to come and transform the metal. And the only reason this happens, something begins to happen because it's made of, or there's an essence in there. You vibrate through the knowing that you are born and made of and created in the image of God. That there has, for you to be something means that something else has to be within you. So for you to be of God means God is already in you. For you to, for that gold to transform the metal, the lead, there has to be gold already in it. So it is that we realize the divine is already in you. You are of God. It just has to be an awareness. It has to be awakening. It has to be an understanding. I am of God. And when I understand that, begin to see that we begin to change because something is already there. And you can only be one with something that you're similar to. Let's get this. How many of you have tried to mix water and gasoline? Anyone be successful in creating a new element with water and gas? How about water and oil, you know? Maybe salad oil, and you try to mix it with some water. What happens with that? Those of you who cook, you know, it never mixes together, doesn't it? It's constantly always separate. The only way it can become one is if there's something within the other element. So the water and something else can become one when there's something within the water that's of like, that attracts, that blends together. You cannot commune with each other. You cannot connect with each other if there's not some similarity. You can't commune with God if there's not some similarity that connects you, that you'll mix together when you're stirred up. That's right, because you're born of God. There's an essence of God already in you. It's already inside you. And so there's a communion. There's a connection. Would you recognize it? It's within you. Today's the day to recognize. Divine presence is in you. You can commune with that. You go within, going within into your thoughts, into your heart, into your very essence. Just know that the circumstances have no power. And when you begin to awaken to this understanding and begin to visualize that you have the power, you're going to be an overcomer. I want you to visualize the power and presence of God at work through your life. What does it look like? What does it look like when God is working through your life, flowing through you? What does that look like? I want you to visualize that and talk to that vision. I want you to talk to that vision. Say, I see you. I see you, vision. I see the power presence of God. I see you in me. I see that working. I begin to see it. I want you to talk to it. And I want you then that you begin to talk to it so much that you talk from it. That's right. You know how you talk to something so much that you begin to talk from it because you know it and you understand it? I want you to talk this vision. The power of God is in me. I see the power of God in me. I see it in me. And before you know it, you'll start living from it. It's going to be transformational and you will become it. And you'll release that which is already within you. And you'll find this amazing power. So I want you to make sure that as you go through your day, that you talk about what you are, not what you are not. Because a lot of us spend a lot of our day in conversation about talking about what we are not versus what we truly are. We truly are the divine expression of God. You truly are born of God. You truly are the expression, the essence of the divine. You truly are the power and presence of God here and now. How about talking about that? Because that's who you really are. Instead of, oh, I'm just this human. Oh, I'm just frail. Oh, I can't do this. Oh, I'm not possible. You know, we talk about all these things, and that's not really true. Because the divine power and presence in you is filling you with infinite possibilities for your life. So what happens is there's a shift that takes place when we start talking about who we really are and talking about our possibilities. Wow, change your conversation. Change your conversation and start talking now about, I am able, I am born of God, I am the power and presence of God, I am the light of the world, I am the light here, I am the overcomer. The power and presence of God is at work in me, and I can speak to those challenges and they're removed because that's who I am. I'm Daniel. I'm fully equipped. I'm Daniel. I'm fully equipped. I can face the lion. I want to tell you this, that the experiences you're going through that seem so challenging and so troublesome are there for your purpose, for a divine purpose, for you to understand and exercise the experience of being fully equipped, of being Daniel, of going within. When you face the lion's den, where do you go? We go within. We go with it.